We have x plus 1 equals plus or minus the square root of 13 over 3. Now you may be wondering why it doesn't look like I took the positive and negative versions of the square root of the left side of the equation. But with this equation right here, we're actually covering all of our possible solutions for x. Here's why. We know that if we have a square root of a number and we make that negative, then that's just equal to negative 1 times the square root of that number. The negative version of this square root of x would then be negative 1 times that, which is negative x minus 1. Let's say that we had this in an equation as well, with the same thing on the right side. Then we're effectively taking care of the plus and minus versions of the left root. This is going to give us four different equations, which are these four equations right here. However, we need to notice something special about these equations. If we take this equation, negative x minus 1 equals negative root 13 over 3, and we divide both sides by negative 1, we end up with x plus 1 equals the root of 13 over 3, which is just this equation up here. That means that one of our equations in the second pair is the same as an equation in the first pair. Now, if we did the same thing for these two equations, the two we haven't touched on yet, we'd find that they are equivalent as well. So if we take the positive and negative square roots of both sides of the equation, we actually end up doing the same thing twice. So it saves us some time to only put the plus or minus in front of one side of the equation, and just take the positive square root of the other side, or the negative one if you prefer that.